The Voyager missions. The two spacecraft Voyager missions superseded the original Grand Tour plans to visit the five outer planets in the late 1970s, which would have used four very advanced spacecraft. Rather than the initial plan, which was canceled in January 1972, due significantly to expected costs, estimated at $1 billion, NASA suggested sending merely two spacecraft to Jupiter and Saturn in 1977. The two new Pioneers, Pioneer 10 and 11, were designed to gather more information about the two gas giants than the previous Pioneers. Using gravity assist operations, the second Voyager might be directed at Uranus, then Neptune, if the first Voyager was successful. Slow-scan color TV cameras were installed on each spacecraft to take images of the planets and their moons. They also have several instruments for studying the planet's magnetic, atmospheric, lunar, and other aspects. When NASA Administrator James C. Fletcher announced on March 7, 1977, that the two spacecraft would be renamed Voyager, they were formerly known as Mariner 11 and Mariner 12. Voyager 2. As early as April 24, 1979, Voyager 2 began beaming back images of Jupiter's atmosphere to be used in time-lapse movies. On its way into the system, unlike Voyager 1, Voyager 2 made close passes to the moons of Jupiter. A 10-hour volcano watch was required by scientists who wanted to learn more about Europa and Io. Io, Amalthea, Ganymede, Europa, and Callisto were all included in the stunning photographs it sent back. In addition to the previously discovered moons, Ganymede and Ganymede. Europa was also included in the stunning images, as well as Io and Amalthea. At 22 hours 29 minutes Universal Time on July 9, 1979, Voyager 2 came closest to Jupiter at a distance of around 400,785 miles, a distance of 645,000 miles. Thousands of new photographs and information about the planet's ring system, four new moons, and clouds were sent back to Earth. Many noticeable changes were spotted by Voyager 2, including a shift in the Great Red Spot's form and color. The Pioneers, the first spacecraft to fly by Jupiter, found no variation in the atmosphere from one flyby to the next. Two Voyager's cameras could map around 80% of the surface of Ganymede and Callisto, with a resolution of about 3 miles, or 5 kilometers. In the hours following its closest approach to Jupiter, Voyager 2 changed course and sped towards Saturn. After choosing in January 1981 to attempt a mission to Uranus and Neptune later in the decade, this trajectory was greatly affected. On August 22, 1981, 2 years after it had left the Jovian system, imaging of the moon Iapetus indicated the beginning of its encounter with the sixth planet. Despite being 14,290 miles, or 23,000 kilometers closer to Saturn, Voyager 2 began its predecessor's photographic mission. In 1981, at 0 hours 21 minutes Universal Time, Saturn and the Earth made their closest encounter, at a distance of around 63,000 miles, or 101,000 kilometers. Information from the Voyager 2. When Voyager 1 discovered the F-ring and its shepherding moons, the spacecraft provided more detailed images of the ring's spokes and kinks. Saturn's A-ring may have only been about 300 meters thick, based on information from Voyager 2. As it ascended above and behind Saturn, the probe flew through rings at an average speed of 8 miles per hour, or 13 kilometers per second. During this phase, the spaceship was blasted by thousands of micron-sized dust grains, which created puff plasma as they were destroyed. In response to the frequent changes in the vehicle's attitude caused by the particles, the attitude control jets fired automatically. Voyager 2 photographed Saturn's moons Hyperion, the hamburger moon, Enceladus, Tethys, and Phoebe, as well as more recent discoveries of Helene, Telesto, and Calypso. Even though the primary goals of Voyager 2's mission had been met within its two planet visits, mission planners decided to send the veteran spacecraft on a trajectory for Uranus. This journey would take about 4.5 years. The spacecraft's approach to Jupiter was explicitly designed to make future flybys of other planets easier. Due to the limited time Voyager 2 got to observe Uranus during its flyby, the geometry of the encounter with Neptune was influenced. Voyager 2 was the first artificial spacecraft to pass through Uranus. What happened to the Voyager 2? Earlier that day, on January 28th, NASA said that the spacecraft had shut down unexpectedly and for no apparent cause. It was as though the entire world was holding its breath. At the time, Inverse reported that Voyager 2 went dark immediately before a maneuver in which the spaceship rotates 360 degrees to calibrate an onboard instrument. The spacecraft, on the other hand, has decided not to move. The spacecraft was reportedly using much power because two of its systems were running at the same time. Due to excessive power usage, the spacecraft's protection program was activated. Voyager 2's software promptly turns off its scientific instruments to save energy in the event of a power outage. Moreover, there is only a limited amount of it. As of this writing, NASA has neither acknowledged nor denied that this is what happened. Only time will tell if the agency ever discovers what went wrong. As long as Voyager 2's mission is still active, we can all relax for the time being. With a 5-year life expectancy, assuming all goes well, it will continue collecting data on a space region that humans have no other way to study. Return of Voyager 2. NASA's Voyager 2 spacecraft's onboard computers abruptly shut off the spacecraft's scientific instruments earlier this week to conserve power. The ship is now on the road to recovery after this terrifying episode. Engineers at NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory say that Voyager 2's science equipment is now working and that the spacecraft will begin its normal scientific operations shortly. Voyager 2 was scheduled to make a 3600 roll on January 25th to calibrate its magnetometer. This was when things started to go wrong. When the spacecraft's computer attempted to send the commands, it needed to do the roll. The timing was off. As a result, two systems that would not normally operate simultaneously used much electricity. Because Voyager 2 was powered solely by a single onboard generator, this was the kind of problem that could have put the crew's lives in jeopardy. Fortunately, Voyager 2 and its twin, Voyager 1, were built to tackle this problem. Spacecraft computers found that science instruments were consuming much power and shut them off to save energy for more important activities, like heating fragile subsystems and communicating with engineers back on Earth who could assist in identifying and remedying the problem. Decisions were made to keep it running. The primary heater of Voyager's cosmic ray instrument was turned off in 2019 to detect fast, high-energy particles generated by our Sun or sources outside the solar system. Because of the data Voyager 2 sent back to Earth after it had departed the Sun's wind of charged particles, it was feasible to identify it. Currently, the sensor for measuring cosmic rays is operating at minus 590 Celsius, or minus 740 Fahrenheit, which is far lower than the temperature it was tested for. Thanks to NASA's engineers, Voyager 2 has been in flight for 42 years. To put that into perspective, Voyager 2 launched just 3 months after Star Wars Episode IV, A New Hope, first appeared in theaters. According to NASA, both Voyager 2 and 1 still have several years of scientific value. The plasma sensors and magnetometer on Voyager 2 are still relaying data back to Earth on the thin, dispersed clouds of gas and dust in interstellar space. In November of this year, 5 additional investigations published revised descriptions of the region outside the stellar wind range. The conclusion. NASA's Juno mission, which is presently researching Jupiter and its moons, will be joined in 2022 by the European Space Agency's JUICE mission, Jupiter Icy Moons Explorer, because international space agencies can get away with capitalization sloppiness. There is a launch date for NASA's Europa Clipper in 2025. Since the Voyager's first encounters with the outer planets 42 years ago, there have been 2 or 3 generations of space missions, depending on how you count them. On the other hand, the Voyager probes have rendered all of that history obsolete. They are making progress, at a rate of about 16 kilometers per hour. Although each communication takes longer, and the power supply runs short, they will continue to communicate new data to Earth as they travel further into interstellar space. Because of this, we dub them Voyagers.